Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you a few collage envelopes. I totally fell in love with those small collages. I made those to use actually already colored paper. I've got inside the blue on all of these and outside I've got those beautiful book pages, and I used as a base already colored paper. This is I think it's teal, that color. It's like very light blue, a little bit of green, that but very light beautiful color. So I made those using that already colored paper, and then I was thinking, why do not make my own paper? So here I made watercolored paper, and today I'm coming to share with you how I'm making those envelopes, and we will try to decorate one. So for the base I'm gonna use just clear paper, that printer paper, 80 grammage, just super simple paper. I'm gonna use book pages, I'm gonna use some painting. I'm gonna use this acrylic painting, but you can use the distress ink. You can use actually also watercolors, anything what will color it, your paper. So I'm gonna use this acrylic paint, and I forgot to bring a water, which is totally important thing. So I'm gonna use my drinking water for that. I'm gonna spill a little bit of that water on my table. So what you need to do is make a space on your table. If you don't have glass or a table which you can, you know, use for coloring, take some tray or put on your table some plastic, piece of plastic, where you can make like watercoloring spa. So I'm gonna put there a little bit of that blue color like this. I'm gonna use a brush and mix it with that color to make colored water. I'm gonna spread it all on my table. And in this water, colored water, I'm gonna dip my paper. And that watercoloring makes beautiful, beautiful background. I love that watercoloring background. It always different. And it makes beautiful maps and those splatters. And no one paper you will have exactly same, so it's kind of perfect for artists, for some artistic ending, for some artistic effect. So I'm gonna just dip my paper this way, like this, and then I need to dry that paper. So what I did before, I placed my paper on this cardboard and I let it dry. I'm gonna leave it here. I already prepared paper which is dry. Just bear with me, I'm gonna tidy up my table to make sure it's clean. Like this. So I do have already prepared paper. It looks like this. This was dipping in, I think, in that leftover. So I was dipping like really hard. And for I let it dry, and then I flat it with my hair straightener. So now I'm gonna choose which side I wanna have on the top, and I guess this more colored side I wanna have on the top. So on that other side, I'm gonna use my book pages, and I'm gonna do small collage here. I'm not gonna pay some huge, you know, attention which way I will put those book pages, because I'm not creating any important art right now. It will be like background. And I will make decoration on it. So this is just for make that paper stronger. And of course, you know, more interesting if you do have an envelope where you've got two colors, I mean, book pages inside and colored paper outside, or other way, book pages outside and colored paper inside. It's always so interesting. So I'm gonna use my book pages and I'm gonna cover all this sheet. Those book pages, so I'm making like small collage here, and I don't have enough. I like this book. These are books I read 25 years ago, and I've got loads of them, but I'm not reading them anymore. It's like nothing I want to read anymore. I think I'm not too romantic right now. And they were sitting in the cellar, so they've got that beautiful vintage color already, which works for me, right? I'm gonna cut. Off, make that paper nice and straight, and here I'm gonna use it here. This, just glue it over it, and I'm not even scared if somewhere it's not glued properly, because I will use lots of sewing, so every single piece will be probably sewn. I'm gonna cut these. To make that paper nice and straight. So now I'm gonna use my scoring board and I'm gonna score this paper to create the envelope. Oh, come on. It's everything falling down. So normally I will wait till, you know, that glue will dry properly, but I guess we can start to score. So I want to create an envelope which will hold any 4x6, like those postcards, they are 6x4 inches. And if I want to put this to envelope, I need to make that envelope just a slightly bigger. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to score here 3/8 inch. 3/8 inch here. And here 6.5, which will give me that 1/8 inch a little bit bigger envelope. So 6.5, and then 6 7/8 score line here. 6 7/8. Then I'm gonna flip it this way. So we have 3/8 inch here, and here is that 6.5 and 6 7/8. And my first score line will be 4. Here, 4 inches. 4 inches. And I need to be, you know, careful because it's still a little bit wet from that glue. I don't want to rip it. So first is 4 inches, and second score line, it's 8.5. And this scoring works on A4 size paper or letter size paper, on any, you know, those printer papers. So that's all scoring. I'm gonna move my scoring board and I'm gonna grab my scissors. I'm not sure if you will see that. I should make it with the pencil. I will try to hold it the way where you can see those score lines. Probably this way, maybe. So here I do have that 3/8 inch score line. I'm gonna grab my scissors and I'm gonna cut that score line. Where is that score line? Where is that score line? To this score line here, it's those 4 inches where we started, 4 inches, so till here. And here I'm gonna make a notch or angle cut like this, and same way I'm gonna cut this corner here on the top in angle like this. So what we have this paper that here on the bottom it's like a fold. Oh, come on, my camera. So now I'm gonna flip it this way where I do have those two score lines. Which way I can show you? This way. Okay, so with my scissors I'm gonna start to cut that, not this one but this one, first from the edge of paper till first cross line. And here I'm gonna make that angle cut to this second cross line. So I will have this end. Here is that score line. So I will have from this first score line, I'm cutting to that second score line cross. And here I'm gonna continue with this score line till the end. So you will end up with two folds here. You can fold it straight away, those, and then you will fold this, and we just created our envelope, the base. And fold that last one, and it's flap of our envelope. So it looks like this now. I wanna have that flap in that beautiful, you know, those corners. I wanna have them a little bit in angle, like you can see on envelopes. So what I'm gonna do, this is that flap of my envelope. I'm gonna fold those two corners together like this. So here we've got those folds. Here is that shortest end. This is that flap of that envelope. Here is the score line. So about 1/2 inch above, I'm gonna start to cut in the angle. Just small angle, and I'm gonna make a curve on the end. So when I will fold it again, those two inside, fold. So here I do have the envelope flap, which looks like this. So I have created the base for my envelope, and now I'm gonna start to decorate it. First, what I would like to do is some soft stamping, nothing too bright, too, you know, too complicated. So I'm gonna use this Prima Marketing background stamp. I really love this stamp. It has so many different scripts and types and fonts, and I really love that. So I'm gonna use for stamping and also for distress ink this Hickory Smoke distress ink from Ranger. It's like very dark gray. It's not black, it's very dark gray, and I really like that effect. So I'm gonna use my bone folder and I'm gonna start to stamp somehow. Just that soft stamping, and when I'm going with my bone folder, where I am pressing my bone folder, there I should have that stamping, not everywhere else. So here I will go, I think, this way. Yeah, see? Where you go, where you press your bone folder, there is stamping. And here, I think, this way. And that's probably it. Let me, maybe here it's kind of empty. Yeah, like this, it's good. So just very soft stamping, and I would like to add there also stenciling. And I just bought from Amazon collection of makeup brushes. These, they are different size, and I wanted to try because I know many ladies are using brushes like this for distressing, and it's true, for soft distressing on bigger places, those brushes are perfect, and they are also for me perfect for stencils. Sometimes I do have very heavy hand, and it was happened many times to me that because I do have heavy hand and I'm kind of pressing too much my distressing tool, many times it was happened to me that I broke my my stencil, that I folded that plastic material, and that stencil wasn't that good anymore. So those brushes are actually one of a kind. Like, really, I'm so happy I bought them. And they are just normal makeup brushes. I didn't choose any fancy, you know, scrapbooking brushes. And look at that. How beautiful stenciling it makes. You can press a little bit more to make, you know, darker stenciling, or add there that ink more times. But because those hairs are really soft, so they are just sliding over your, look, if you want to add there a little bit darker stenciling, you just press a little bit harder. And I am so happy I bought those brushes for that stenciling. It will be wonderful. I can manage much more easily where I want to place that stencil, or, you know, where I wanna make that stenciling effect. So I'm on a, I'm gonna add a little bit more. I don't know what I wanted to say. I'm on a. Oh, mama. So really wonderful thing, those brushes. And they make like, tone in tone stenciling. That's amazing. I hope you will see that it's not like everywhere same, that they are making tone in tone. I really love that effect. So if you wanted some good tool for stenciling with distress inks, I guess this one can works for you. And any those brushes you will find, I think they will be same. This was very cheap. No, very cheap. This was cheaper than those others. Not very cheap, but cheap. I will put link down below if you want to have a look. But it's not like I'm working for that company or so. I'm just, you know, I was choosing by price. Because I didn't know how they work. So that's all about the stenciling, and now I'm gonna use my, you know, my usual tool for distressing all these edges. Like this, I'm gonna distress also these edges here and here and here and here and a little bit inside, because when it will be open, I'm gonna match all those that envelope together. So I'm gonna put a little bit of stenciling, distressing inside. So I do have that base done. When it's open, it looks like this. So this is the pocket, back pocket of my envelope. This is the front and this is the flap. So I will concentrate to decorate this. I've got here those offcuts. And I'm gonna try to use them. So first, I think I'm gonna cut. This is, you know, that one of those offcuts. Here is that score line. So I'm gonna cut in that score line just to separate it on two pieces. I've got here this long strip. So I'm gonna use as a first that long strip. I'm gonna open my envelope and I'm gonna use glue and start to glue it down. When it's too bright, like this paper, I'm gonna use a little bit of that black soot, not too much. I don't want to make it dark, too dark. So I'm gonna put glue here on that blue side. And here is the flap of my envelope, so I guess I will start in there. On the flap of my envelope, gonna rip it here, cut it to angle, distress it a little bit, and I'm gonna glue this here. Just using that stuff I've got, and I've got here those strips. They are from those office papers. I think they are called linen papers or linen papers, somehow like this. So I'm gonna glue one strip over it, and I don't mind too much that if it will be not glued properly somewhere. As I said, I'm gonna make sewing effects, so I'm gonna use my sewing machine to secure it. And now I'm gonna use those other sides. So here, I'm gonna use this one straight away. I'm gonna fold that end and cut from the corners to the middle of that paper. So I made that, what is it, fishtail, I think it's called fishtail. And I'm gonna do same, probably. Cut it a little bit longer. Like this, and I'm gonna do same with this one, but I don't have to have, you know, a similar pattern. So one, this one I'm gonna use with that watercolor effect. I'm gonna distress this one, and to give it some kind of more interest, maybe I can, no, I'm gonna just distress it. This, I'm gonna distress this small piece as well with that hickory smoke. Like this. And these two pieces, I need to cut it a little bit. So I'm gonna use this one, this line, to cut it a little bit down. It's too long. And I'm gonna use those to decorate that front of my envelope here. And I'm gonna place this small fishtail over it a little bit, like this. Yep. And as a decoration on the top, I'm gonna use again those strips. So I'm gonna place one here. And maybe I can put this small piece, this one. This one, it's from that other side. So I'm gonna distress it and use that small piece on the top as decoration. I'm gonna use everything I can. Everything I can. I'm gonna place it here. Yeah. And we've got this back side. So here I do have this last piece. What I can do with it? I like that effect. So maybe I can make it in a label shape. I'm gonna cut those corners. You know, like specimen label shape. I'm gonna distress all these edges. Like this. So for the decor, yes, I'm gonna put underneath those strips. It's too long. Okay, like this. And this one I can place actually here because it's already with glue. Yeah. So I'm gonna place it on that paper like this. And I've got here a few more pieces. So here I'm gonna cut those corners to make them look more vintage. Gonna distress it. Yeah, I'm gonna place it here. Which way? I think that way. Just placing, you know, those offcuts, those strips. Decorative way. Not sure where I will place this one. Yeah, I can actually place it underneath. That will be good. Like this. And I think I'm done with gluing the base collage pieces. So what coming now, it's sewing, and I will sew everything all around of this label, maybe all around. First I will start with this small one, then I will go on that bigger one this way. And I will end up here. I will don't sew through. And then I will sew a piece here and then a piece here. Maybe I will sew this one as well. I already prepared one which has all those sewing effects to make it a little bit faster. So I did use that zigzag stitching and normal stitching all around of those edges. So it's just, you know, decorating the envelope with that stitching effect. What you can do as well to punch some holes. Here I used Zutter machine. This is Zutter, bind it all, and I have placed this. This is the front of my envelope. So this side I have placed into my Zutter. Where are those? You know, those marks. I placed there that. Front side of my envelope and punched. So then I have this one, those holes, and to make it visible, once there will be glued the flap, I use distress ink to make it a little bit darker, because here will be glued this flap, so it will be not like a hole through, but to make it, you know, a little bit more interesting, I think it makes beautiful effect. So I do have all that sewing here on the piece. So what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna sew glue it together. I'm gonna put glue on those two flaps. And fold it over. So I do have my base of that envelope done. And I have prepared few pieces to decorate my envelope. And I forgot something. You can also use embossing powder. I think I have showed you. Here, it's with embossing powder. I made embossed effect, and I think it looks really gorgeous. I haven't used my embossing powders for a very long time, so I use it here to decorate that background as well. So you can use embossing powder and do some embossing effect. I'm not sure if I should now. Maybe it's okay without me. Maybe I can, small one. So I'm gonna use one of those La Blanche stamps, because they are my favorite for embossing effect, for floral or flourish embossing effect. The La Blanche stamps are my total favorites. This one and this one. I love them so much. They've got beautiful. What is it? Beautiful. Design. So I have prepared all I need. I've got here heated up sea foam white powder. I'm gonna try to make that white embossed effect. I'm gonna use this stamp. I've got here, this is anti-static powder. I'm gonna dab a little bit, not a little bit, a lot of that anti-static powder on my envelope, where I think I will have that stamping to make sure that embossing powder will get stuck only where I want it. I've got here embossing ink, and I'm gonna put, you know, this stamp is very old, so it's a little bit fault now and it's no good because when I do stamp with it, I'm making like stamping everywhere, mostly those edges. So I'm gonna place it on my envelope and try to press it properly. I'm not sure. We will see. So now that white, sea foam white, and we will see how I did my stamping. And I didn't. Ooh, there is nothing, like literally nothing. What did I do? Why is it not there? That's obvious. Okay, I'm gonna make it one more time, and if it will not work, I'm not gonna repeat it. I'm gonna try different. Okay, I've got here Versamark, so maybe this, it's dry. It's not much better. Ah, that was old one. I've got here this one. This should be more wet. successfully. And if that wheel don't work, I'm gonna move on. So first, put a coat, hopefully now. And if I will be lucky enough, I will place it at a similar spot like before. You know, where there are those layers of paper, maybe that's the problem. That it can't get there because of those layers. Ah, it looks better now. It looks like it's there. What's wrong with you? Do I have some different one? I've got here some different white embossing powder. Maybe it's not even because of my ink. Maybe it's because of that embossing powder. Who knows? I'm gonna give it a try. No. Not much. No. Oh, come on. Okay. No. I'm not gonna continue with it. So sorry. I wanted to show you how beautiful effect it makes. So we will be without embossing powder effect. I'm just gonna make small layout on it. I'm sorry. Where there is a will, there is sometimes not way. Okay, I did prepare for myself few pictures and few decorative elements. I'm gonna very carefully wipe it down because it's full of that anti-static powder and full of that embossing powder. So what I'm gonna do, what I'm gonna try to do, I'm gonna try to glue the my prepared pieces. I've got here one picture. This is from my collection on Etsy, Blue Witty collection. There are this is collection with birds. I've got here some offcut small labels which I had in my stuff. This is label or specimen label made from book pages. I've got here this number 5. This is dye. I have shown it when I made those postcards. I showed that die. It's Marianne Design die. It looks like this. These numbers are a really great size. I love that die. It's on my favorite list of dies now. And here you can see the number C like Charlie, O like Oscar, L like Lima, 1418. So it's the number of the die. And I have found it on Amazon. So go to have a look if you like that die. And I will try to do something here. Yeah, what I can do. And just, you know, some small layering. Yeah, I've got lace. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my glue. And I'm gonna do some small layering here. I think I'm gonna use this some way with the blue or with that. Yeah, with the blue. So to make it visible, I'm gonna distress the edges of this piece. Which way I'm gonna place you? And these labels I made from my scraps, you know, from those leftovers, kind of ish leftovers. Yeah, no, which way I'm gonna place you, which way I'm gonna place you. I can place this one here. Of course I can. No. Ah, unagi. Ah, I've got also masking tapes. So maybe we can add there small amount of masking tape. Just strips here and there. And I like this masking tape. It has very, very delicate writing, so I think I would love to have it there. Yes! And if I will place this over it, yes! So here will be actually... what's wrong with you? Oh, come on! Okay, bear with me. I need needle. And I'm sorry, I just punched the camera stand. That's usual. Ooh. Okay. So I'm gonna place here the piece of lace for that soft decorative touch. And here can be, yeah, it can be here, but I will need something underneath. It's like, you know, that lace has some thickness. So I'm gonna use, here I've got a piece of cardstock. I'm gonna use just a piece of cardstock to glue it here. Yes, it can fit there. To make straight, even position for this label. And I'm gonna place it right here. Okay. Especially on that. Right here. And same I will have to do now for most of my images. I mean for those bigger ones which should be glued on the bottom. This I'm gonna glue right here, I think. I will need for this picture some background steps. Okay, I'm gonna cut it this way. And I'm gonna cut it here and here. Place it that way. A little bit down. Yeah, that can work. All right. I think the best way, I'm gonna glue it straight away to that picture. Just make sure that I'm on the right, right corner. Here. And now I'm gonna put a glue here and in this corner. That corner will probably sit on there like this. Yes. And I've got this teeny meeny small label here. So I'm gonna glue that teeny meeny small label here on the top of that. And this I can slide underneath. Yeah, that was a good choice, actually. I totally forgot about this small piece. How I will place you here? Aha, this way. I do understand now. Okay. So this I'm gonna slide into both those pictures, and here I'm gonna use that specimen label and glue that specimen label here. And then the number 5. Yeah, maybe this way. Or I can place it this way. And number 5 here. I like those steps, you know, when pictures are going in steps, but no, I wanted to have it here. Yes. So glue there. And number 5, it's kind of shiny. So maybe I can try to match it together. I've got here acrylic dabbers. This is espresso. So I'm gonna start with espresso, and I'm gonna just dab a bit of that espresso acrylic paint on that number 5. Where is my heating tool? Oh, this is too long. And I thought it will be like quick. It's never is too quick. Then I'm gonna use this white one. This is Picket Fence Distress Paint. And I'm gonna do same. I'm just gonna, you know, dab here and there, not too much. Just like this. And I'm gonna heat it up, so it will get settled. And that piece, that number 5, is cut out of metal can, which I glued on a cereali piece, on cereali box. And here, now it's too hot, so I need to wait, because it's metal, you know. It's metal, so it's kind of hot, and I'm gonna just here and there. Add to those edges that blue, and the blue it's distress paint, broken china. I'm gonna show you how it looks like. I hope my camera will zoom. Yes. So it looks like this. It's really like very rusty piece, so I'm gonna glue that down right here, and I think I will be done. Oh, sorry again. I'm gonna take my glue, and if I will come with another decoration, maybe I will. You know that embossed powder effect, it's so gorgeous, and I know it will look amazing here, but unfortunately you saw that sometimes, you know, it doesn't work the way we want. So this is my sharing. I thought it will be shorter, but yeah, it is how it is. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you will try to do your watercolored paper and maybe some collage on that paper. It's so It's so amazing when you see how it grow up, those things we learn from each other. So use them on making some projects. It's so amazing when you can use all that stuff you have. And I have to start to use everything I have because I've got so many, and I'm mostly working just with paper and glue, and that's so shame. Sometimes I'm editing, you know, of course, distress inks I'm editing all the time. Sometimes I'm editing, what is it, laces, but mostly I'm working just with paper, and I do have so much amazing colors and all that stuff, so this way, hopefully, I will try to use it all ever again, all over again, not ever again. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. Thank you so much for visiting me. Thank you so, so much for all your amazing comments. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.